Since there are a number of areas in which a contamination can occur, we have to look at this in terms of layers of safety. And just as when we drive in our cars, we don't rely upon any one particular safety device, we still buckle our seatbelts, we have airbags in our cars, we have anti-lock brakes, we have collision avoidance systems, we have a lot of things in our cars that contribute to our safety. It's the same concept with administering hazardous drugs. You can't rely upon any one particular system because nothing's going to be 100%.